We heard from journalist Richard Paolo, who described the scene to our John Voss.
You can hear the police helicopters above me. They've been circling the sky for some 6 to 7 hours, and on the ground, there are hundreds of police scattered across this residential part of North London. They basically tried to drive something in the region of 300 to 400 protesters, I would imagine, and push them back. But there have been bottles thrown. There have been a lot of attacks on the police themselves. I must say, I haven't seen too many injuries, but it's a very, very volatile situation, and it's certainly not calming down. I mean, you won't get any sleep in this part of North London tonight.
And Richard, just walk this back. This all started out, I understand, as a peaceful demonstration over a shooting of a father of four there?
Yeah, absolutely. Mark Duggan, who was the father of four, was shot in North London on Thursday, and about 20 to 30 members of his family and friends marched to the police station today in a very peaceful protest. But from there, it has escalated. Now, obviously, many of the people involved in these incidents have nothing to do with the friends and family as such, and there'll be many questions as to just who they are. But basically, it escalated from that. We had police cars torched. I've seen one alight again about 20 minutes ago. A very iconic London double-decker red bus burning in the middle of the high street. Shops on fire. I've seen a residential house on fire. At one stage, I believe there were some people trapped in there. So it's absolute chaos, and it's not showing any signs of slowing down.
And part of the chaos, that there is a report that protesters, rioters, broke through police ranks and attempted to storm the police station there?
Absolutely, they did. That's where the first two police cars were set on fire. And as you can probably hear, there's a police helicopter going right over my head at the moment. But very much the police station on the high street was the focus. But now protesters have looted many shops and they're still causing widespread disruption in this part of North London.